Hey everyone and welcome back to the channel. And today I'm going to show you how to get the Google Assistant working on a Sonos smart powered speaker, even if you're living in a country that isn't officially supported by Sonos. So before we get into it, don't forget if you like the video, please click the like button down below. Also hit that subscribe button and the notification bell down below as well to be notified of any new videos that I publish in the near future. So with that out of the way, let's get into it. So you've got yourself a Sonos smart powered speaker and you want to get Google Assistant working on it. Now at the moment Sonos only officially supports 18 countries with which Google Assistant will work on that Sonos speaker. So if you live in one of those non-18 countries, like the other 250 in the world, and you try and add it to the Google Assistant, this is what happens. You go into the Sonos app, you click on add a service, click on voice and Google Assistant, and you will be greeted with the not supported in your country page. Now, I live in New Zealand and I get that message because it's not officially supported. For many people, that is it. They just stop and assume that they can't get it working, or they'll go and switch to Amazon Alexa. Now, Amazon Alexa is supported in a lot more countries than Google Assistant is, and if that works for you, that's great. Personally, for me, Google Assistant, I think, is a smarter assistant, and it works a lot better for me with a lot of the other systems that I have in the house as well. So for me, I really needed to get Google Assistant working. Fortunately, there's a workaround, which means pretty much anyone in the world can get this working if they do this little hack. And this is what it is. It's got nothing to do with the Sonos app itself. It's got nothing to do with the Sonos speaker. It's to do with your Sonos account. So what you need to do is put the app and that aside for the moment. Go to the Sonos.com website. Scroll down to the bottom. There's a Manage My Account button. Click on that, log in, and go to your profile page. Edit your profile. In there will be a country. Now, the chances are that it's actually the country that you bought your Sonos speaker from. You need to change that to one of the supported countries on that list. So you can change it to Australia, the USA, UK, Germany, wherever, it doesn't really matter. Just change it to one of those countries. Save your profile, very important that part. Now, go back to the Sonos app, log out of it if you haven't already logged out. Now log back in again and try and go through the adding a Google Assistant flow again. So click on services, click on add a voice service, Google Assistant. Now, instead of being presented with a not supported option, it will now start taking you through the add to Google Assistant flow. So it will ask you what speakers you want to be added to Google Assistant. For me, I've got one in two different rooms, so I added both. It'll ask you whether you want to share some data, and it'll also ask you for an address as well. That's because it uses that for localized weather service and things like that. After you've entered your address details, you'll then need to select a default music provider. So for me, that's Spotify, but for you, it could be YouTube Music or any other service that you've got synced up at the moment. After that, it's going to ask you whether you want to allow personal information. This is so you can ask the speaker things like, what is my calendar? What alerts do I have? So I tend to turn that on, but you could skip that or say no thanks if you didn't want that. Once you've gone all the way through that flow, then you come out the other side and that's it. Your Sonos smart speaker should now be set up with Google Assistant. So now, if I go to my Sonos one in the family room now and do this.
Okay, Google, play music.
Okay, playing Fire on MARZZ on Spotify.
You can now hear music playing out of the speaker. And that's it. It's not a particularly complex workaround, but it works. Personally, I would rather Sonos just naturally supported more countries, but they seem to be pretty slow going in that regard. So this at least gives you a workaround until they just support in your country. So the two gotchas I came across whilst I was trying to do this. One of them was when setting the country in the Sonos.com website. When you log back into the app, sometimes it would still take you through to the not supported in this country page. And this is due to the cache settings that the Sonos app has on your phone. So what you need to do is you need to go and clear the cache. So you need to go into the settings of the phone. So on an Android device, it's settings, apps, then search for your Sonos apps. If you click on that Sonos app, there will be a data option. And in there, you typically see like a clear data or clear cache options. Now you want to make sure that you clear the cache button, don't clear data. If you clear data, it'll clear your login, it might clear your room data and everything else as well. So just clear the cache. Then on the Sonos app, if you log back into the Sonos app again, you should now be able to go through and complete the Google Assistant joining option. Second gotcha I came across was once this was all set up on the Sonos speaker itself, when I went to ask the Sonos speaker to play, I got a response saying, I don't understand that. This is because in the Sonos app, there is a default music output option. And after you've added all the speakers, it doesn't set it in the Sonos app. So you need to go in there and do it yourself. So go into the Sonos app, go through settings, go to the Google Assistant settings again. And this time at the bottom, there should be a default music output option. Click on that. And click on the speaker that you want to output once you've asked Google something. And then you will find that the next time you go and ask the speaker to play, it will now play music. Okay, and that's it. It's pretty short and sweet, but I hope that really helps people. For me, it was almost a lifesaver. I bought the Sonos speaker because it would allow me to add Google Assistant. I had to wait, 18 months or something before they actually put it onto the speakers. And then to find out that my country wasn't supported, I was pretty annoyed. So having the workaround is really good for me. I've got them set up in the house now. So I hope that helped. Again, like and subscribe. And until next time, see ya.